PCR, the polymerase chain reaction. This has got to be a DNA replication sort of thing. Let's look at DNA replication and see if we can't see something in there that looks like the polymerase chain reaction. PCR starts with the origin of replication. At the origin of replication, the DNA is melted. Replication forks go off in both directions, forming a replication bubble. The replication bubble actually can be seen in the electron microscope. The leading strand is fairly straightforward. A primer is put down. The DNA polymerase, one polymerase, finds the primer and starts adding trinucleotides 5' to 3' as the replication fork moves forward. The polymerase moves forward. The lagging strand is much more, it involves the same enzymes, but it's much more complicated. There's a primer that's put down, and the DNA replication adds bases, but the bases are added backward, and so it constantly has to be started, finished, sealed, started, finished, sealed, and it's somewhat messy. Furthermore, the replication fork causes kinks in the DNA, and the kinks have to be straightened out with gyrase. So gyrase allows the DNA to spin around. Well, what does all this have to do with the polymerase chain reaction? Actually, we can see the polymerase chain reaction in this little drawing. The polymerase chain reaction is all about the leading strand. PCR has one enzyme. The leading strand has one enzyme. Polymerase chain reaction has one primer. The leading strand has one primer. So if you take the two leading strands and reduce DNA replication down to the two leading strands, you have polymerase chain reaction. And of course, in PCR, the primers are made out of DNA, so you don't have to swap them out for RNA. The elegance of it is pretty overwhelming.